Lindsay, for those of you new to my channel, and today we're gonna have a little fun. Normally I talk about fashion and beauty tips every Saturday, but today I wanna talk about the top fashion mistakes women are making right now, because it's got to stop. I really wanna start this video off by saying I am a huge advocate for personal style. I think you should wear what makes you feel good, but I also think when wearing what makes you feel good, you also have to think about the event or occasion that you're going to, and you need to dress appropriately. That is the most important part about dressing up and going into the world. Where are you going? And you need to respect and dress accordingly. But today I wanna talk about the mistakes, the bad, sloppy things people are doing out there, and I just gotta talk about it. If you're new to my channel and love this video, please make sure to give me a little tap, tap, subscribe on that button below. And I'm also on Instagram showing my outfits every single day, so you can follow me, my handle somewhere down there, and let's get to the low down dirty mistakes. I don't mean to be that dramatic, but let's just get to the mistakes. All right, women all over the world are wearing pants that are too tight. Now, the pants that are the trickiest are work trousers. You know, a lot of times they have stretch. And telltale sign that your pants are too tight is when you're standing there looking in the mirror, like this example I'm showing you. If you're standing there not moving and they are pulling from hip to crotch, you see that whiskering and pulling, they're too tight. Too tight, size it up, girl. You know what? And if you don't wanna wear a size up and you're like, oh my gosh, I'm always a size 8, I don't wanna be a 10, I don't wanna be a 10, size up and cut the tag out. So that way, in your mind, you're still an 8. That is a little tip, because I'm telling you guys, it looks better to go a size up than walking around looking like a busted can of biscuits in your pants. And also, in a professional setting, it's just, it's sloppy, it's not sophisticated, go a size up. This is also, you know, the trouser pockets, the pockets that are slit on the side, the trickiest pockets of the world. If they're bowing out, or if you're standing there and they're buckling in and they're pulling, size up. Do not chance it, I promise. You will look more flattered, streamlined, your outfit will look better if you size up. And again, the trick is just go a size up and cut that tag out. It's funny, when I was styling celebrities, a lot of them were always so neurotic about their sizes. And just like everybody else, sometimes they gain weight. So when they would gain weight, we would literally cut the sizes out of their clothes so they wouldn't get all in their heads. So that's a good trick, and I suggest you use it. This next mistake was something that I personally was an innocent bystander of when I was at an event a few weeks ago. So if you are going to wear sandals to a professional occasion, to work, to an event, to an evening out, to a date night, anything that doesn't have to do with being at home and running errands, if you're gonna wear sandals, you need to do a foot check. I was at an event, a work event, a very, you know, prestigious event a few weeks ago, and I was talking to this girl and she was so sweet. And when she sat next to me and crossed her legs, there was this huge cracked dry heel. It was enough to turn my stomach. Now, some of you guys maybe are be like, oh my God, Lindsay, you're so harsh. And I don't know if there's like a medical issue with that, but to me what it looked like, it was just, she hadn't got a pedicure in like 30 years. In your real life, if you're running errands, if you're at home, who cares? Like, do whatever you want, don't get pedicures, I don't care, don't have toenail polish, whatever. But when you're going to a professional setting or an event where you need to be dressed up, I think you need a pedicure, and I think you need to do the heel and foot check, get a little polish on your toes, or do a little scrub down on the heels so that your look is polished from, you know, head to toe. I think it's important. How we present ourselves is truly the reality, you know, a reflection on how we take care of ourselves and take things, you know, seriously in professional settings. So that's just how I feel. Do the heel and foot check before you wear the sandals, please. I was like, ooh, pedicure,
emergency, pedicure emergency.
This next mistake should honestly be common sense, but I encountered this mistake a few weeks ago, so I thought I would talk about it. So a few weeks ago, I was interviewing assistants, and I don't know, this girl may be watching this video. I'm sorry, she was a super nice girl, very qualified. But when she showed up to the interview, she was wearing a baseball hat. And I just feel that no matter what job you're interviewing, whether you're interviewing to sweep the floor, pick up garbage, or you're interviewing to be a legal assistant, you should always show up polished and in a sophisticated manner. Unless maybe, I mean, I even think even if you're interviewing to be like a scorekeeper or work, you know, in the sports industry, you still show up with your hair nice and a conservative or simple outfit. I just felt that this girl, when she showed up with the baseball cap on, I just felt that she didn't care, and she already was like really comfortable and she didn't care to wash her hair or do her hair. She just literally threw on, and this is I think the exact hat, like a blue hat. And it just showed me right away, if she's that comfortable to show up that casual and not put any effort into her look in the beginning, how is that gonna be down the line if I hire her? And call it a judgment if you will, but it's really important. First impressions say everything, especially when I don't know you and I'm interviewing you to work for my company, and that's any company. You need to show up polished. Wash your hair, put it back in a ponytail, whatever it may be. Do not show up in a baseball cap, especially to a fashion job. Like, hello? No athleisure normcore job interview outfits, nope. And to piggyback on that last fashion mistake, the next one, and this person I interviewed may or may not have done this as well, but when you show up to a job interview or any professional situation, make sure your clothes aren't wrinkled. Like, do not just let it pass. So if you guys follow me on Instagram, a few weeks ago, I did a story where I'm like, I had a wrinkly shirt on and I was just going to run errands, nothing major. And I was like, guys, should I wear this top? It's wrinkly, but I kind of don't wanna, you know, steam it or iron it. And everyone was like, it's fine. But that's fine in my own life and in a casual atmosphere. When you're showing up to a respectable event, interview, a professional event, you know, a wedding, you need to do the wrinkle check. Now, I understand through wear things get wrinkly, like that's understandable. But when you're showing up to an interview with me and it's clear that you got wrinkles in places, like it's all a wrinkled mess, like you pulled that out of your laundry basket, it just again shows a little less respect for the situation that you're in and the job or the event that you're going to. So take some time to really get yourself put together. I say the number one easiest way to get rid of wrinkles is a steamer. I don't use an iron unless I'm like starching something, which is like never. I have, and I will include the link to the steamer that I use every day. I mean, I steam this outfit with the steamer. I will include the link in the description below. It's just really easy. You plug it in, the steamer gets hot in seriously like 30 seconds and you just steam and go, so easy. And I definitely, sometimes if I have like wrinkles in a pocket or a sleeve, yes, I will use a flat iron. I'll just get up in there. I don't know if that's bad that I'm telling you guys to do that, but I'm an adult, I'm careful. And for a quick fix, you know, a little clamp the little wrinkles out and I'm out the door. So make sure, wrinkle check. It just shows that you care. Otherwise, it just shows that you're a little sloppy. So this has been happening for years. I think I've even talked about it in videos years ago. Women, stop wearing your leggings as pants. You know, your cotton leggings that you're supposed to wear under things or wear with long tops or shirts or even under dresses, stop wearing them as pants. They're not pants. And you know, a lot of times when you wear your black cotton leggings out like pants, you know, with your short shirts, a lot of times they're see-through and I can see your underwear, and in worst cases, I can see the color of your booty skin on your butt through the fabric. It's just so tacky, it looks sloppy. If you have got to wear your leggings out, at least go get a pair of substantial, like workout pants or something, but just don't try and slide in your leggings as pants. It feels very juvenile. It feels very young. Like, I guess I'm okay. I'm definitely okay with, you know, elementary school kids. They're so cute wearing their, you know, their little leggings as pants. That's fine. But once, you know, you start getting over the age, you know, of 25, 30, a little older, it just looks sloppy. It looks very young. It looks, you know, just a little unkept, and I'm not a fan of it. I think there's so many other options. Go buy some skinny jeans, some super comfortable skinny jeans. It's just, unless they're workout pants, do not get ready for your day or your evening and try and pass off your cotton leggings as pants. I'm just not a fan. Some of you guys are gonna hate me for that, but I'm telling you, in the daytime, the light hits, I see your red lace panties, it's just not a good look. It's doing bad. Now I need to know, do you guys agree with these fashion mistakes? I need to know, so leave me a comment in the comments below. And also tell me if you disagree. I wanna hear if you're like, Lindsay, that's crazy. I wear my leggings as pants all the time, or my pants are too tight. I mean, I don't know, whatever you gotta say, I wanna hear it. Please let me know. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please tap that button below, because I upload videos every Saturday, and I would love to see your faces. Well, I really don't see your faces, but I would love for you to see mine. I don't know, this is getting weird and it doesn't make sense. But anyways, subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you guys next Saturday. Bye, everyone.